Our guest tonight has the greatest job in the nerd universe. He is one of the most renowned transmedia producers in the entertainment industry, having worked on amazing projects such as The Pirates of the Caribbean, Avatar, and The Amazing Spider-Man. He's here with us in the Dubai Talk Show. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor to present Jeff Gomez.
Thank you so much.
Welcome to our studio, Jeff. Welcome to Dubai.
Fantastic to be here.
Have you been before in Dubai? How do you feel?
I've been in Dubai once or twice. I think I can spend a whole week in your airport. but no, I've been enjoying such conferences as the Middle East Film and Comic-Con, which has been spectacular. I've been interested in cultivating transmedia and entertainment business in the region.
Mm-hmm, I see. Tell us a little bit more about you. What does a transmedia producer do? This is actually, it sounds quite fancy as a title. It was accredited officially by the Guild of America, the producers, in 2010.
That's right.
What is exactly the profession of?
A transmedia producer is someone that joins a production. Whether it's a movie or a video game or some other interactive type of production. And the transmedia producer is responsible for making sure that the content is robust, is expanded so that it can play in different ways on different media platforms. So my job is essentially to look at the next blockbuster movie and say, you know, the world can be extended beyond the edges of the movie screen. And you can take that world and explore it in a video game, or learn what happened before the movie in a novel, or in a website online.
So what kind of media, what kind of media channels and different vehicles this storytelling goes?
Well, for example, with James Cameron's Avatar, which was so fantastic to work on. We had to examine this world so that we could advise the video game producers how to take certain aspects, certain creatures, and show us different elements of the world. Or for example, with Spider-Man, there's part one and part two. What happened to Spider-Man in between these two movies? We dramatized this in a Tumblr site online with articles from the Daily Bugle, which kind of officially helped to tell the story of what happened to Peter Parker and Spider-Man in between the movies.
Yeah, usually what is the duration in between the movies could be, I guess, 1 or 2 years, five
Correct.
Years, and even more.
Yes, sometimes.
So it's a big gap. It's really important to keep the audience really into this. It's like tweeting more or less every day, in a way, right? Isn't it?
Movies sequels can be released anywhere between 1 year and 3 years, usually. And the thing is that these studios are spending so much money on these motion pictures, hundreds of millions of dollars. And they know that, these days, they know that the audience is not going to watch the movie many, many, many times. They get tired of that, especially when there's so many other choices, right? The market is very competitive. So the idea is if the audience loved this movie, perhaps there can be different content that can keep the audience engaged with the story world, with the characters and the creatures or all the sorts of things that are in this world. And that manifests as video games, comic books, novels, social media implementations, and things like that. So for example, between the two Spider-Man films, there can be a Tumblr where the Daily Bugle is publishing articles about the adventures of Spider-Man that happen in between the two movies. And this was a successful implementation.